One Piece chapter 823 review. I just want to say I'm sorry this review is so late, but let's get into it. Now, I've not seen anyone else's reviews for this chapter, even though by the time this video is up online, it will probably be Monday, the week after the chapter will be released. So I know that's pretty surprising, so I don't know what the community is thinking, but I personally found this chapter to be pretty boring. So, we get to see the characters that will be representing their individual country going to the Reverie. I'm not really going to go over it all because you read it. You can read the chapter yourself if you want to know who's going. There's no point in me going over that. But I will talk about the stuff with Vivi. Now, Vivi is being escorted by the Marine, Hina. Yeah, you may remember Hina. She has the devil fruit ability to create cages. Yeah. I've always thought it'd be really cool, by the way, if Hina could create sea stone cages, but in hindsight, that'd be pretty counterproductive, considering, you know, devil fruit user, sea stone. Yeah, that'd be pretty counterproductive. But the point is that Vivi is most certainly going to be very important in this upcoming arc, or not even arc, whatever happened with the Reverie. Mainly because she got like 4 pages. No one else that was introduced that would go into the Reverie got a large amount of screen time or panel time. Vivi got like 4 pages dedicated to her and the people from her country. We do get to see that her father does mention that he wants to marry Vivi off. I have a theory about that, but I'm going to hold the theory and probably make a video on it when I feel up to it. I'm not feeling the greatest at the moment. But, yeah, so I'm not going to mention the theory here. But, you know, her father got very old in 2 years. Like, borderline unbelievable. Like, borderline Oda is kind of just pushing this. Like, he probably wants to kill Vivi's father off. And then so he can find some way to make Vivi the ruler of Alabasta, make her the queen. Which I'm not against. It's just, you shouldn't really just kill off the character. Find another way to kill him besides age. It's pretty clear he's trying to kill him off. He has made him, like, old. But her father does admit to wanting to learn something from the world government about the Podoglyph, based on what Nico Robin said way back in Alabasta about her dream getting her too many enemies. He's curious to what the original king of Alabasta did all those years ago that the world government is so desperately trying to hide. However, so we do get to see all the other people, as I said before, that are going to the Reverie, all the other kings and queens. However, the person from the Go-O Kingdom, the Go-O Kingdom, I think it said, I don't really know, I'm kind of tired, but the person that's leading that is Sabo's brother. Yeah. That jackass is the king of the kingdom that the main character grew up in. I find that kind of disturbing. Sabo's brother is going to be there. Now, you know what? I'm not going to talk about this anymore. And I'm just going to skip to the end of the chapter and talk about what everybody wants me to talk about. Because that was really the only thing that hyped anybody up at all chapter. So after we see all the kings and queens preparing for the Reverie and departing, we skip over to Luffy and his crew, or the people he's sailing with at the moment. And, you know, this is kind of comedy, a lot of funny stuff. Nami says she'll try to cook some food for the crew. She doesn't know if she can feed Luffy. Luffy gets pissed off. It's relatively entertaining. My translation may not have been the best either. But, let's all be honest. So, a new crew arrives, and I think it's Pedro, who is like, whoa, this is big news. So apparently a new land has been discovered, Baltigo, and it is already in ruins, and it is the base of the Revolutionary Army. This means that it is possible that Blackbeard won the fight between, you know, him and Dragon. Do I think he won the fight? No, I do not. I believe Dragon destroyed it himself. I believe once Dragon realized the location of his base had been discovered, he decided the best thing to do would be to try to make it appear as if he had a fight with the Blackbeard pirate, or something had happened and the base was destroyed. I honestly just don't see a fight between Blackbeard and Dragon being that ending like that. I honestly don't. I think last year is the weakest Yoko, and I personally myself believe Dragon can hold it own against Shanks. And you may disagree. I think Blackbeard is the weakest, Yoko. I think Shanks is either the second strongest or the strongest. And because I think Dragon can hold his own against Shanks, that obviously would say that I think Dragon can beat Blackbeard. Now, of course, this is all just pure speculation. I'm just guessing here. But this was obviously the most interesting part of the chapter. I mean, it's interesting. It is really annoying because this is just a case of Oda skipping over what we want to see once again, and that's annoying, because honestly, if they did fight, which I don't think they did, I think Dragon did it himself just so he could, you know, make people think that the Revolutionary Army's base was destroyed and they would be weakened, but they're actually all fine, they just left the base and blew it up or something. But no, if Blackbeard and Dragon do end up fighting, like if they did fight, if that is what happened and Oda skipped that, I could even do a video. I mean, that awesome stuff Oda has skipped since we got to the new world. Let's think about this. Sabo versus Burgess, round 2 in Dressrosa. After he got the Flare, we didn't get to see much of that. Let's all be honest, his fight with Fujitora was also kind of cut short. The Akainu and Aokiji fight, or Kuzan now. It's so many epic things, and now we're going to skip this? Now we're going to skip Blackbeard and Dragon? Like, if that did happen, I want to see it. But we probably won't. This chapter, all in all, I found not much happened. It was really just showing who would be at the Reverie. While it is important, I didn't enjoy it very much. And if I had to rate it, I'm going to get hate for this. I would give it a 3.9 out of 5. I know. But really, the only parts of this chapter I enjoyed were the first, like, 4 or 5 pages with Vivi. And then the last, like, 3 pages with Luffy and all the other people on the Sunny. But yeah, so I would rate it like a 3.9 or whatever I said before out of a 5. But guys, I hope you enjoyed my review for One Piece Chapter 823. Remember guys to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell me what you thought of the chapter in the comment section down below. And have a great day.